different connections of capacitors. Capacitors can be connected in series or in parallel. In series Now here, in this series means one after the other. Suppose if this is one capacitor, this is positive, this is negative, the other capacitor is joined like this. Then this setup is called series. Now in this, if a charge of Q is drawn from the battery, that should be passing through C1 as well as C2, because it has to come back to the cell from the negative terminal. So we can say, as there is no other path for this charge, the charge accumulated by these two capacitors will remain same. Now as their capacities are different, the potential drops across C1, let it be V1, and across C2, let it be V2, should be equal to the potential difference across the two terminals of the battery. So V must be equal to V1 plus V2. We know that Q is equal to CV is the equation for capacitors. So here I can write Q, because V is equal to Q by C, and this is Q by C2. Why did I write Q only for both the two? Why not Q1 and Q2? Because we discussed already, the two capacitors acquire the same charge. So here, now if I replace this by a single capacitor which is having the effective capacitance, then it should also draw the same charge. So therefore I can write here V is equal to Q by C effective. Now if I compare these two equations, in place of this V, I can put Q by C effective. Therefore, Q by C effective is equal to Q by C1 plus Q by C2. So, as Q is common in all the three terms, I can cancel it. And finally, I can write 1 by C is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2, which clearly tells us that when two capacitors are joined in series, their net capacitance will be reduced. Even this can be understood directly also. Suppose when you are making these two in series, then what is you can imagine, so this is first plate of the first capacitor and this is the second plate of the second capacitor. So this distance, let it be D1, and this distance D2. So here you can understand that the distance between the plates is getting increased. As we know, C is equal to epsilon naught A by D is the formula. When D is increased, then the capacitance will be reduced. So in that way, also it can be supported. Let's consider that these two are identical capacitors of having C. then what should be the value? The C effective must be C by 2. That means here in place of D, we have taken 2D. So C becomes C by, C effective becomes C by 2. So this is all about series. So this is one capacitor. Now I'll connect these two in series. So series means one after the other. Now let me show the capacitance first individually. You can see that it is 0.006. Now I would like to show you the capacitance of the second capacitor. The second capacitor is 0.07. So this I have connected these two like this, and then I can put this. So now this capacitor is in series with the other capacitance. Now you can see the value is reduced. So when the two capacitors are in series, there the value of the net capacitance will be lesser than the individual capacitors. This is C1, this is C2, and this is battery of potential difference V. Now here if you place this capacitor positive and negative, the other capacitor like this, and these are connected by wires, then this represents the capacitors connected in parallel. Now let us derive the effective capacitance for this. Again we consider Q charge is drawn from the cell. Now here at this point, which is known as nodal point, there are two paths. So some charge will flow through the capacitance C2 and some will go through C1. Anyway, because of law of conservation of charge, you can write Q must be equal to what? Q1 plus Q2. Now here, as we know, Q is equal to CV. I can write Q is equal to C1V plus C2V, because this capacitor is also connected across the same cell. This capacitor is also connected across the same cell. Therefore, the potential difference between the two plates of first capacitor as well as between the two plates of second capacitor should remain same, and which is equal to the potential difference across the two terminals of the cell. Therefore, I can take V as common, C1 plus C2 times of V. Now, if I say that these two capacitors are replaced by a single capacitor with the same cell having the same potential difference V and drawing the same charge Q, if you consider that this is C effective, then for this capacitance we can write Q is equal to C times V. This C is C effective. Now if I compare this equation and this equation, I can write C effective times potential is equal to C1 plus C2 times V. Now I can cancel out this V as it is same. C is equal to C1 plus C2. That is, in series, the capacitors are added up. again, if you compare the combined arrangement, what we are doing actually, both the two are connected like this. Up to this, one C1. Then second one is C2. So you are not increasing the distance. What we are increasing the area. So as we know, C is equal to epsilon naught A by D. Here A becomes A1 plus A2. So as area is increased, that is numerator is increased, the capacitor must be increased. So C must be equal to C1 plus C2. If you have taken the identical capacitors, then this A becomes 2A. Therefore, C effective must be equal to twice C, where C is the capacitance of individual capacitors. These are the two ways in which capacitors can be connected. We will talk about different combination of connections of capacitors while doing the numericals, and then we will come to know how can we tackle the numericals. These two capacitors are connected in parallel. So in parallel we know the value of the capacitors will be added, because each was 0.6, now it is 0.11.